It's the National Football League on EA Sports. And if it's in the game, it's in the game. It's the Eagles and the Pats. And it's all up next.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Mass. Today, it's the opener of the 2023 NFL season, as it'll be the Philadelphia Eagles taking on the New England Patriots. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Well, CD, new season is here. Lions and Chiefs got it going on Thursday night. You and I were there. What a scene that was. But now here we are a few days later on Sunday, looking at two teams with great expectations. The Patriots defense ready to go here in the Sunday night opener to this new season. And the one we'll be watching is this man at corner.
So many times when he's on the field, you hear announcers like us talk about how calculating he is when he goes for the football. And what they mean, he has a high football IQ, and he eliminates all the errors that could happen and makes big plays as a result.
The play fake. Here's Hurts. They'll buy some. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
It may be cliche, but it is something that holds up over time, doesn't it? If you're the visitors, you don't want to let the crowd in the game early.
Yeah, and that's exactly what they did there. But you said also this defense, they're going to give them a lot of looks like we just saw there, aren't they?
They certainly are. They're a proud unit, and they're going to ride the momentum of this crowd with them, and that's why they got after them early.
Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21.
Throwing is Hurts. Open man, that's Devontae Smith.
And he'll go out of bounds, looks like right at the 15. And that's good for a gain of 6. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here. Tall task ahead of him here, needing a full 15 yards to move the chains. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Jawan Bentley in there to drop it for a 6-yard loss, and that will lead to fourth down.
Well, that's the second time he's been sacked so far in the first half. And if they have designs on having a big year, on going anywhere, they've got to find a way to keep him upright so they can throw the football.
The Pats defensive unit back out there. They lead 7-0, trying to put a stop together here as this drive starts with a first down. Now a man picked up on draft night this year, DeAndre Swift.
And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage.
Matt Judon there to bring him down.
Well, they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10.
Hurts sets up to throw it.
And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack. It'll go on the books as a 7-yard loss on the sack. And it's third down.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Eagles in possession as they've got it with a third down and long coming up. Hurts.
Passing game not in sync here early, and now it's fourth down.
Well, that play was certainly a little bit different because on the previous play, he was sacked. This time, protection a lot better, had time to survey the field, and still couldn't find an open receiver.
The New England defense back on the field. They've had the upper hand so far this first half of play, working with a good lead already as they look to defend this first down. But first down, Hurts. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. Well, this is really an interesting matchup here in week one. Of course, you got the Super Bowl 52 rematch to talk about. No Nick Foles or Tom Brady on the field today, but for the Eagles, it's been a long wait to get back at it again since the loss to the Chiefs back in February.
And no Zach Ertz. Was it a touchdown? Was it not a touchdown? In New England, they're still upset over that call. But hey, this game is going to be a blast because the Eagles, they didn't feel like they put enough pressure on the quarterback in the Super Bowl. They want to really get after him in this one.
They'll try and pick it up by running the option to the right. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. A gain of four that time as the drive continues. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Here's Hurts to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
Well, one of the linebackers has got it.
And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. He was under duress, surveying, trying to find somebody to get the ball out of his hands. In the meantime, the defense, they took it out of his hands.
And when the ball snapped, I know exactly what the defense is thinking. Get a sack, put him on the ground. But when you can also knock the ball free while doing so, oh, there's the bonus for you as a defender.
The Pats defensive unit back out there. They've looked good so far. This whole team has, for that matter, in the midst of a big first half as this next drive begins first and 10. On first and 10, it's Hurts. Complete. Smith has it. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. Now they got to get to the line quickly. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. He shakes him off. He finds his man, complete. It's Watkins. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. A gain of 15. They'll throw on first down with Hurts. Now a timeout called for by the offense, as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Another try after the first down sack. Hurts. Hurts fumbles it, and it's picked up by the Patriots. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. He already had the one fumble lost, so now two fumbles lost here in this first half.
Not setting the pace the way that you want it done. I mean, here in the first half, already twice the ball's come out and hit the turf. Gotta find a way to take care of it. Otherwise, they may have to start thinking about maybe someone different at that position.
The New England defense back on the field. They'll start by looking at a first and 10 at the 25. From the gun, it's Hurts. And this is incomplete. Very lucky to get that one back. That nearly picked. It's second down now.
It's now second and 10 at the 25-yard line.
looking to throw. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Dropped incompletions on first and second down. It certainly seems like a reflection of what we've seen so far in this game. The defense, cooking to the punch so far. Let's see if they can get something going here on third down.
This time they stay on the ground. And they'll indeed stop him on third down. And now what do you want to do with your timeouts? No gain on the play there. Nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on fourth. The run on third and long, so I guess waving the white flag a little bit.
Yeah, and I think sometimes teams are so committed to running the football that they'll take a chance, even in a long yardage situation, to let them know.
The Pats defensive unit back out there. They'll play with a lead here to begin this third quarter. Looking for another solid half of football to carry them to victory. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. That's caught by the big tight end, Dallas Goedert. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 16 yards right off the bat and a first down.
If Goddard doesn't miss five games last year, there's a good chance he gets Philly a third 1,000-yard receiver. Just getting better and better, now entering his sixth season.
He'll find Swift out of the backfield. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Now whistles and a stoppage here. Looks like one of the Eagles is in some discomfort out there. Well, you always hate to see injuries, especially tough here in week one. Just hoping this is nothing serious. We'll take a quick timeout. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. This is Swift on the counter, and he edges forward, but only gets a pair of yards out of it, and it's second down. That ground game contained again there, Charles, and that's really a big reason that they're trailing right now.
And give a lot of credit to that defensive front. That's exactly what they worked for all week, to try and take away the run game, make them one-dimensional. In the battle of game plans, theirs has been superior.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
Had an open man that time, man, to put a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely, just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. On third down, he'll drop to throw. Oh, and Hurts is going to be hit and taken down to the ground. Multiple defenders get to him there, and that is the sixth time he's been sacked in this ballgame.
Looks like another empty possession here, partner, and I don't think, with three scores down in the third quarter, they can truly afford any more the rest of the way.
No, especially the way their offense is sputtering. I think you're exactly right. They got to find some answers quickly. New England defense back on the field. They've done a really nice job of slowing the tempo of this offense, and as a result, they've got a comfortable third quarter lead as this next drive begins, first and 10. They'll come out throwing here on first down. The Pats are going to get there. Down he goes. Davis in there with pressure yet again. That is the seventh time that they have dropped him here this afternoon.
This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. We've seen it demonstrated time and time again, to the tune of seven sacks in this game thus far.
That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. He'll look to throw, buying time to his left. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down.
Oh, partner, just a second earlier, and they might have had him because they certainly thought they were going to close in and drop him behind the line of scrimmage, but he had just enough time to dodge the pressure, and he ends up getting yardage before being stopped.
These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. But it's caught on the right side of Smith, and he's not going to sniff the first down here. He's stopped at the 25. Calling a gain of 6 on the play, and that's going to make it fourth down.
So much
understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks, don't let them get there, and they rallied and made the tackle.
The Pats defensive unit back out there. They've pitched the shutout here into the fourth quarter. Been sensational. The question, can they finish it off? They'll need to come up with another stop here. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Over the middle, complete. And Smith will go down as a gain of six, and that'll bring up second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Being chased, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Matt Judon in there to get him once again. That's two sacks for him now here on opening day.
Guys with his talent in the pocket aren't supposed to be getting hit like this. And you know an intense conversation with the offensive line is going to occur after this one. Might not be from him, but the offensive line coach will have plenty to say about this game.
Now the throw on third down, knocked away and incomplete.
I like the confidence of how he played the ball here. No panic in his eyes as that throw arrived. Tracked it from the moment it left the quarterback's hand, and that's just where he needed to be to knock it away.
They're going on fourth down with Hurts. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Eagles unable to convert there on fourth, and the Patriots take over. They're going to have terrific field position. The New England defense back on the field. They've put in a very good shift so far, and this one pretty well in hand. Just looking to finish strong here in the fourth as this next drive starts first and 10. Throw here on first down. That is incomplete.
Even with such a big lead late, the effort hasn't lapsed one bit. If the offense wants to score some points in this one, they're gonna have to earn it. These guys are not giving up anything.
So following the incompletion here, second and 10 from the 25. They'll set up to throw. That's complete to DeAndre Swift out of the backfield. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Philadelphia picking up the first on a gain of 15.
Nice game there, partner, but you and I both know that won't do anything for the final score. They're not going to win this one. Right now they're playing for pride and fantasy points.
And just to erase that goose egg, nobody wants to be shut out.
Great.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. Oh, and Hurts is going to be hit and taken down to the ground. Dropped for a loss of seven by multiple defenders.
Well, it's obvious, but I can't help but say it here. It's never a good day when the opposing defense has more sacks than you have points. The win seems likely, but this defense is still playing for something here. They see that zero on the scoreboard, and they don't want that to change.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Another try after the first down sack. Hurts under pressure. They got him again. That time, multiple defenders getting pressure, and it's a loss of six. Yeah.
So this will wind up a victory for the New England Patriots. And I tell you what, Charles, this might be about as good as it gets. They were incredible.
Yeah, offense was in fine form. The defense threw the shutout at them. I think they worked in concert together. What I like about the offense was they held the ball pretty well. You know, time of possession, exactly what they were looking for in this one. And that helped out their defense. Didn't have to be out there the entire time. So when you do that and you're out there fresh playing, off a little extra spring in your step, and it showed up in this one.
They had a ton of spring in their step. Impressive victory. So for the Pats, you can't ask for a better start as they pitch a shutout here in the opener. And they'll get to stay home again next week. Meanwhile, for Philadelphia, they go down to defeat here in the opener. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week.